We want to welcome everyone to this January 22nd, 2024 meeting of the CISD Board of Trustees. This is a regular meeting and all items that will be discussed have been duly posted. While this is a meeting in public, it is not a meeting of the public. If you wish to speak, please register in the lobby on the audience for guests form and follow the information on the speaker form. The board's role is to set goals, approve personnel and budgets, make policy, and provide oversight. We are not here to manage or solve individual problems. Management is responsibility of the superintendent. As a board, we believe that we must educate every child, provide every child the greatest opportunity to learn, and maintain a safe and secure environment mentally, physically, emotionally, and academically. And these are our core values, and we appreciate your interest in the students of CISD. All right, we are going to go to the Pledge of Allegiance. This is from Bowie Elementary, and I will introduce the students. Colt Lahan, Nathan, okay, I'm sorry.
Maka Younga,
thank you. Jada Franklin, Ezra Ross, Belinda Padron, and Ryan Castanet.
They have something they would like to present to you first.
Let us pray. In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit, Amen. Come, Holy Spirit, and fill the hearts of your faithful, and enkindle in them the fire of your love. Heavenly Father, we give you thanks for the great work of the Independent School District of Corsicana. We ask you for the members of the board, that you may enlighten them, give them wisdom in all the decisions that they have to make. We ask you that you may protect the students and their families, the faculty and staff of all those in the different schools of the city of Corsicana. We give you thanks also for their dedication, their work, their sacrifices. Give them a hundredfold. Protect them from the evil one. Give them communion to work together for the glory of your name. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen.
Special friend to Corsicana ISD. Dr. Kevin Brown is with TASA, Texas Association of School Administrators, and I've known him for many years now. We appreciate his leadership. School districts in Texas are better because of his leadership, because he's there at the helm of TASA. And not just school districts, but we have better schools for our children because of his leadership. So it's quite an honor to have him here tonight. And I'm going to ask Dr. Brown to come forward.
Thank you, Dr. Frost, and thanks to President Brown for having me here and members of the board. I'm really honored to be here this evening. Tonight's a big night. As I was driving in today, I was reminded of my grandfather, who was a minister in Texas. He was a circuit rider, and he would get on a mule and go from town to town and preach. And one weekend, it was a big rain, and he had to cross the river, and he made it in, and it was a full congregation. And he turned around and said, "I've never seen this many people here. What's going on?" And they said, "Well, somebody that crossed that river must have something important to say." I don't know. I'm not important, but you are, and I do have something important to say. And driving down I-35 is not the same as crossing the Frio River, but it was a little rainy getting up here today, and I'm really honored to be with you today. My name is Kevin Brown. I'm the executive director of the Texas Association of School Administrators, and since 1971, we've been honoring the best board in the state of Texas each year. So for over 50 years, we've done that. I'm here because the Corsicana ISD Board of Trustees, the team of eight here, has been named as the best school board in the entire state of Texas out of over 1,000 school boards in this great state. And for that, I say thank you and congratulations. I have more things to say, but we need to give them a big round of applause, don't you think? Like I said, we've been doing this since 1971, and it's a big deal to us because we believe that public education is a cornerstone of democracy. It's where every child in our communities has a shot at the American dream. It is a very important in developing community members for your local community. It's important for our state's economy, and it's important for the future of our country. And for that reason, you are important people. You do it as volunteers. You do it, I hope they'll double your pay after this. We just greatly appreciate the fact that you give of yourself so willingly, and you do it as a model for every other school district in the state of Texas. For those of you in the audience who don't know, every region gets to pick one school board. So in your region here, we were able to have you be selected from your entire region, which is a really big deal in and of itself. Those 20 districts and school boards have paper applications, and there's a review committee that goes through and reduces that from 20 to 5. And then on September 30th at the TASB convention in Dallas, those 5 school boards were interviewed, and Corsicana being one of those 5, and then we were able to select one school board out of all of those that were a part of this as the very best, and you're to be commended for that. I do want to say that the other school boards that were recognized were also outstanding, just not quite as outstanding as y'all, but that included the districts of Crowley, Montgomery, Texas City, and Isleta. And we do want to give a big thanks to all of those boards for doing such a great job. The selection criteria includes the board support for educational performance, educational improvement projects, and school transformation initiatives, as well as the board's commitment to a code of ethics, community relations and involvement, and financial support for the district. The selection committee also looked at the board's own development as a team as they worked together for the benefit of the community. The committee was impressed by the board's focus on the whole child, as well as the trustees' commitment to their community and advocacy for students on the local, state, and federal levels. And I can say not only have y'all done that as a board, but I've known Dr. Frost for a long time, and she is a huge advocate, not only for Corsicana, which she is a very passionate advocate for, but also for public education across the state of Texas. And collectively, you have a very powerful voice, and we appreciate you using that voice in support of everybody. Members of the committee noted that the board's committed to children and focused on changing student lives in very real, visible ways that impact their futures. To this board, it's not just about graduating kids, but it's about preparing them for the future, that they're going to go out and contribute, whether it's in Corsicana or in another community in our great state or country. Communities should be proud of the Board of Trustees in Corsicana. The committee described the board as innovative, creative, and forward-thinking, and they said they embody the concept of the team of eight. It's very easy for a board to just come to an issue and people vote whatever. That's easy. What's hard is to have those long and hard conversations and come together as a team on behalf of the school district. And it's very impressive what you have done collectively as a team. One of the most important jobs you have is hiring a superintendent. And y'all hit a grand slam. Dr. Frost is a first-class leader, very well respected among her peers. I actually knew her as a grandmother in my school district when I was a superintendent. I got to serve her grandkids. So she's just a special lady, and I know she feels very blessed to be a part of this community and a part of the board. I also want to say thanks to Jerry Mays and Tom Norris, who are at the service center and were a part of this process and this program in naming y'all as regional winners. Dr. Norris was my superintendent when I was a teacher back in 1993, 95 in Round Rock ISD. And I liked him so much, we got the same barber. Corsicana ISD Board of Trustees demonstrates what an effective board can do. If they're allowed to work together with the superintendent and with the community on behalf of students. We believe this board is extremely deserving of the title of 2023 Outstanding School Board without question. They embrace our mission at TASA, which is to create and sustain student-centered schools and develop future-ready students. On behalf of the Texas Association of School Administrators, we offer up our utmost congratulations. And if that's okay, I would like to ask each of you to come forward. I'll call your name. We want to give you a plaque that you can take home on your own, and then we have another plaque that we'll give to the entire board, and maybe we could get a group picture of everybody up here when we're done, if y'all would just be patient for a minute as we celebrate this big award. So without further ado, I think I've got some good help over here that's going to give me some. And just full disclosure, Dr. Brown and I are not, President Brown, and I are not related. I know it's hard to believe, last name's as unusual as Brown, but we're going to ask Dr. Seth Brown to please come forward first as board president. We can give him a round of applause. Next up is our board vice president, Leah Dill Blackman. Next up, we have our secretary, Barbara Kelly. Next up, we have Kathy Branch, trustee. Next, we have Jamie Roman, trustee. Next, we have Kamar Chambers, trustee. Next, we have Brad Farmer, trustee. And we also have our superintendent, Dr. Diane Frost.
So, on the first one, we have a black for you that we hope you'll put in this wonderful room. I see a couple pictures, y'all. And when I saw your pictures on the wall, I thought, well, I know all these people. I've seen these pictures on the website and everything. But this is the plaque that we'll have for your central office, a picture of them, and this will be up in perpetuity as the honor board for the entire state of Texas. And this is a memorable historic occasion. I'm going to be right up in here with you. I'm going to hand this to you.
Well, thank you very much. We really appreciate that. And driving all this way.
Absolutely.
Perfect segue into the superintendent's report.
I'd like to welcome back all of our staff and students. We had a wonderful break, and so we are enthusiastically beginning the second semester of the school year. We kicked off this semester with a great motivational speaker, Damon West, who came and talked to staff and then to the students at the high school and middle school. He encouraged us to positively influence all of those around us and to live our lives as though we were coffee beans. And so that's a great analogy that he uses to talk about being positive people and to having a positive impact on everything we do. Speaking of positive, we have several high school students that we'd like to spotlight. Our senior calico captain, Brittany Barreto, was recently named All-State Dancer and performed with the fellow All-State Dancers at the Texas Dance Educators Association Convention in Houston. So we're very proud of her. Senior Alexis Samaniego attended the UIL State Congress meet in Austin, and she competed in an event where she lobbied. Something we love to see our students doing is learning how to use their voices. She lobbied against donor and legacy admissions to college, which is something she feels passionately about. And this week, sophomore Maxius Gomez is scheduled to compete at the Dallas Golden Gloves Tournament, so we wish him very good luck there. Thursday evening, we have a very important event. Our high school counselors are hosting the FAFSA Fiesta Bash, and they're going to offer assistance in filling out FAFSA forms for high school seniors. Chips and salsa will be available, and they'll have door prizes. So we hope that all of our seniors who haven't completed their FAFSA forms will show up with their parents or guardians, and we'll get those done. I want to also allow Dr. Mays, I think he wanted to say a couple of things, but before he gets up here, because Dr. Mays, this is superintendent's report, so I get to talk. I just want to thank you for your service. Dr. Mays has announced his retirement from Region 12 Education Service Center, and I think there are so many things in Corsicana ISD that we can thank our service center for. He's provided stellar leadership. He's been the person that on those days when I'm not sure who to call, it's just like 1-800, call Jerry. He always answers. He always has a word of advice and some assistance, and he will provide any support that our district needs at any level, whether it's a teacher in the classroom or a question from the superintendent. So we have appreciated every year that I've been here. He's been the director at Region 12. His leadership has been paramount in the many successes that our district has experienced, and His staff also should be recognized because he hires really well. So we want to thank you, Dr. Bays, for your service and your commitment to our students, and especially all that you've done for Corsicana. So if you want to come up and say anything now, it's your turn.
Thank you for those many kind words. You all know, and this staff knows, and the board especially, that what a great privilege it's been for me all this time to watch the great work that you do, because you know how committed I am to board and superintendent leadership. It continues every day to be my firmest belief that the future and the direction of the school district are established by the longevity of quality folks serving in that role. So thank you for continuing to be part of that. Everything that my friend Dr. Brown said, double underlined again and again, about Dr. Frost and you all and the work that you do here. So we got all excited about this, as you might can tell, and we decided what would be something that we could do to kind of help mark the occasion. Well, as it turns out, we got with our friends over at the Texas Farm Bureau, and I don't know if you've been out there yet today or not, but I went to check just to make sure. We rode out, we got to town a few minutes early, and if you're on the northbound side of I-45 along about the College Street Bakery, there's an electronic billboard up there, and it now says Corsicana ISD, Board, yeah, all of that, and it's a really sharp picture of you guys. So thank y'all very much. Thank you for giving me a moment to talk about this and to congratulate you. And I hope you enjoy seeing that billboard as much as I did. And the folks in Texas deserve to know what a great job you've done and you continue to do. Thank y'all so very much. See you soon.
Just before that, I remind everyone that February 5th through the 9th is our winter break. I want to take this opportunity to thank our school board. This is School Board Appreciation Month, and I appreciate them always in January as well as every other month of the year. We wouldn't be able to do the things we do. We wouldn't be able to serve our students and our staff the way we do if it wasn't for this board, which is not only dynamic and committed, but also visionary. Very important people in this community and in this state. And I don't think we should overlook how very important you are at not only in Corsicana, but at the state level too. Boards look to you as leaders. They look to you for role models, and they look to you for what they would aspire to be. So thank you so very much for all that you do.
We are going to go into closed session for a moment, as permitted by Texas Government Code Section 551.01. Resuming open meeting. Do we have any actions as a result of closed session?
Mr. President, it is my honor to nominate Class 84 Coach Eugene Rogers for Corsicana ISD's head coach, football coach.
Is there a second?
It's with my honor that I second that.
Okay, we have a motion to hire Coach Eugene Rogers for the head football coach. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed say no. Ayes have it. Congratulations.
Can I say something?
Sure.
I want to welcome Coach Rogers, and I want to thank everyone. We had a very high level of interest in this position, and I appreciate that. I am so excited to have Coach Rogers here because he's a Corsicana guy. He knows what it means to be a Tiger. He is blue and gold. He has experience winning, coaching at the highest levels of state championship games, and what he brings is not only coaching expertise, but it is his heart, and I think everyone is going to see that. And when I think about our players and what they need and our coaching staff and what they're looking for, it's tough. And it's leadership and it's commitment and the willing to do the hard things and put in the hard work. But most of all, you have to remember why you're doing it. And he knows his why clearly. And with all of his heart, he can tell you how much it means to him to be a Corsicana Tiger. So welcome, Coach. Welcome to your family. And we cannot wait for you to be fully in Corsicana. And we're going to, I believe, Mr. Lennox has something he's going to send out. Maybe about 10:30 tomorrow, we're going to have an opportunity for some staff members and players to meet you. And thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, we're going to get into our discussion action items. So we're going to go to the audit report by Patillo, Brown, and Hill.
Well, after hiring head football coach, we are very excited to hear about our audit from this year. We're going to ask Travis Rogers to come forward and coach us up on the audit.
Hey, I'm also Rogers, just helping me out a slightly less interesting. But if you try not to make this class too terrible long this evening, but Dr. Frost, members of the board, thank you all for having me. Like I said, my name is Travis Rogers. I'm a CPA until Ryan Bill, based out of Waco. Just here this evening to share with you very briefly the results of the fiscal year 2023 audit. You should all have with you a copy of the annual financial report for anyone who wants to follow along. Just going to go here and hit a couple of high points real quick. I'm going to start not all the way at the beginning, but very close on page number 2 on our independent auditor's report. This is going to be the same letter that you're all used to seeing every year, which just has the standard language, which lines out our responsibilities as your auditor to render an opinion on your financial statements based on our audit, also the responsibility of the district's management for the preparation and fair presentation of those financial statements. Most interesting part, they changed the order of it here in the last couple of years, where now they don't bear the lead. The opinion section, which everyone cares about, is all the way at the very top on the first page. Which you can see where it says in the second paragraph, in our opinion, the accompanying financial statements present fairly in all material respects. So that's what we call an unmodified or clean opinion, which is the highest level of assurance we can provide as your outside auditor. Basically means as a result of our audit, no findings, no material departures from GAAP, no other issues worthy of being reported as a part of this report. So it's well done, clean audit, no issues or findings there on financial statements. We have, because just one letter isn't enough, we have another one that looks just like it towards the back, beginning on page 74. Same general idea here, except instead of being over the district's financial statements, this is over the district's federal single audit. You know, entities that expend $750,000 or more of federal funding year after year are subject to the single audit. We go in based on various criteria, select federal grant programs to test for compliance with federal requirements. So same thing here, same general language, laying out the basis for our opinion,
I do have one question. On page 43, section J, first I was going to just see if you could explain that section, what actually it is.
Yes, ma'am. The section J, the shared service arrangements, those are essentially the shared service arrangement is essentially a cooperative of multiple districts around the region for any number of purposes, special education, there are a few others. But primarily, essentially how those work is that the districts pool their resources and have a single district that serves as the agent for that cooperative that manages the operation of those programs for the arrangement, if that makes sense.
It does. And then with that, Corsicana is listed twice in the list. Is that supposed to be there? Is that accurate?
Yes, ma'am. I believe that the one very all the way down at the bottom, Corsicana ISD, that's the district's expenditures as the agent. I believe they're also included as a participant in the program. Hmm.
This is the Deaf Ed program.
Okay.
So Margie has all the details on that if you want all the details. But that's what this is, the Deaf Ed program that we, I think it's 49 districts, is that right? 49 districts, and we're the district that runs the Deaf Ed program.
Okay. So if it's for the Deaf, so is it the Deaf Ed program for the first one that listed, and then there's two Corsicana ISD?
She doesn't have this in front of her.
Okay.
I haven't seen the numbers.
So we're the fiscal agent for that group.
Mm-hmm.
So essentially, we are an equal participant or entity to those things. But one part of our agreement. Okay. So what that references at the bottom is the amount of federal entitlements that we actually get. So we get, because we're the fiscal agent, so the grants that come from the Fed come to us, and then we bill out shortfall to these member districts based on the cost of each student that we serve. So we have students within our district that they bus to us, and then we have districts that we go out, we have staff that goes out to them, and then we have students that we just check on. So all of those are broken down by formula to bill out to those districts to cover the shortfall of what the entitlements do not cover. So while of course at ISD we receive a large sum, it's not enough to run the program, so then that gets filled out. And so what you see up at the top, the Corsicana ISD at the top, we have the most students. We're the biggest district as well in there. So that was actually essentially our cost for our kids.
Okay, that makes sense. Thank you.
If there's not any more questions, I do want to thank Brian and Sean and Jeremy for their hard work on this. They keep us up to date every single month, and an audit is nothing personal for auditors, but really not fun. We really appreciate the work of your firm, and we appreciate the work of the people in the district to make sure that everything is done the way it's supposed to be. So thank you all.
Well, if there's no questions or discussions, I'll entertain a motion to accept the annual financial audit.
I move that we approve the annual financial audit for the year ending August 31st, 2023.
Okay, we have a motion and a second to approve the annual financial audit for year ending August 31st, 2023. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed say no. Ayes have it, and we have approved the annual financial audit for the year ending in August 31st, 2023. Thank you very much. Right. Now we're going to pre-K kindergarten registration and timelines.
Dr. Frost, Dr. Brown, members of the board, I'm happy to share this. Kindergarten registration time. So Carroll Early Learning Center pre-K will have an information meeting as well as registration on Thursday, March 21st. At Carroll Elementary, that's in Houston with Mr. Horn. We'll have a pre-K kinder information session on March 26th on Tuesday at night. That's when the parents will hear about the Houston School Language Program and they'll sign up for their students to be tested with that program. And then kindergarten for Louie, Carol, Fannin, and Vero, Thursday, April 11th, Thursday, April 25th. They will have parents can come in and register their students for the 24th year. And then we will have additional days for Mr. Betts to be at different campuses throughout the month of May for pre-K and Carol. Some things that we're working with, Wayman Communications, we're going to be sending out postcards to the county. Just to remind everyone, if you have a kindergartner, a four-year-old, or a five-year-old, our registration dates of those for the pre-K and kindergarten students. We're going to do videos. Mr. Betts has asked for one. As well, our fourth graders visit fifth grade here at the time as well, and then we'll have banners to advertise.
Thank you. Demolition bids for Traverse Elementary.
Did they give you a time frame of how long it might take them
yeah,
to
so
complete
we've,
the project?
We've been doing some kind of preliminary work. We have to get them a sheet that kind of breaks down a few things. They'll turn that in to the state of Texas. I think there's a 10-day window that the state of Texas has to reach out and do any kind of on-site checking and stuff like that. Once the project starts, I don't think they think it'll take too long. They haven't really given me an exact time on that. And once again, the state of Texas can come in any time, make sure we're following all the asbestos guidelines before we're taking materials and stuff like that. But I mean, I would estimate once we get started on the actual demolition, it should take a couple of weeks to really do it.
What was that?
Sorry?
What was that?
So I think that all is part of the knee shaft. I don't know exactly what the process is. I do know that because the building was called Red Town as a hazard, that they can do a wet demolition, which means they'll spray an area as they're doing the demolition and keep all the dust and parts and stuff like that from getting in the air. So I think that's one of the things they're doing. But I think they have all the guidelines.
Well, we've seen this on our board book. Does anyone have any other questions? If not, I'll entertain a motion. So, a motion and a second to recommend review and approve Neighbors Demolition LLC to complete the demolition. Travis Elementary due to fire damage. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed say no. Ayes have it, and we will approve Neighbors Demolition LLC to complete the demolition of Travis Elementary due to fire damage.
Thank you.
Thank you. Raise your hand, Texas Trustee Advocates Program.
Dr. Brown and members of the board, we are very proud to have been chosen as members of Cohort 2 in the Raise Your Hand Texas Raise Your Hand Texas Trustee Advocates Program. This is something that is ongoing for the next couple of years, and it is an opportunity for school board members to be trained and to learn more about advocacy, particularly at the state level. So this is an honor, and I'm asking tonight that the board approve our participation in this advocacy program.
All right, I move to accept Corsicana ISD's participation in the Raise Your Hand Texas Cohort 2 Trustee Advocates Program.
Second. We have a motion and a second to accept the Corsicana ISD's participation in the Raise Your Hand Texas Cohort 2 Trustee Advocates Program. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed say no. Ayes have it, and we are going to accept the invitation to be the participant in the Raise Your Hand Texas Cohort 2 Trustees Advocates Program. Okay, we have consent agenda. We've read through that already. Do we have a motion to accept the consent agenda?
Do we accept the consent agenda as presented?
Do we have a second?
Second.
We have a motion and second to accept the consent agenda. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed say no. Ayes have it, and we've accepted the consent agenda. Mr. Lennox, do we have any audience for guests tonight? Thank you. Okay. We are now going to adjourn into closed session as permitted by Texas Government Code, section 551.01. Thank you very much.